Guess what? China has announced plans to launch an artificial moon into our skies by 2020. And as crazy as that sounds, it's not actually the first time something like this has been attempted. But first, China's new plan. As reported in China Daily, China plans to launch an illumination satellite into orbit above the city of Chengdu. Well, actually four illumination satellites. The first as proof of concept in 2020, and the next three as the real deal in 2022. There aren't a ton of details about the satellites themselves yet, like how big they are or what they'll be made out of, but we do know they'll be covered with a reflective coating similar to the moon's, whatever that's supposed to mean. At the proposed distance of 500 kilometers, a single satellite is expected to illuminate an area between 10 and 80 kilometers, with light around 8 times brighter than the moon's. If all goes to plan, the scientists hope the moons will replace streetlights in urban areas and save the city millions in electricity costs annually. They could also help light up streets during natural disasters and blackouts. Those same benefits are what prompted Russia to try something similar 20 years ago. In 1993, Russia successfully deployed their own prototype of an illumination satellite, about a 20-meter reflective film that unfolded in space. For a few hours, it orbited a couple hundred meters above Earth, beaming a 5-kilometer-wide spotlight over Europe. But that light only moved at about 8 kilometers an hour, meaning most people just saw a flash in the sky as it passed. Eventually, it fell out of orbit and burned up on re-entry. The Russians tried this again a few years later, this time with a 25-meter mirror. However, the satellite failed to deploy and it quickly fell out of orbit. There were plans to launch a third, even bigger mirror, but the project faced serious budgeting issues and was later abandoned. So China's plan is essentially picking up where Russia left off, taking note of their mistakes and making something that will actually work, right? Well, as critics have been quick to point out, that doesn't appear to be the case. The first and probably biggest issue with China's proposed scheme concerns the height of orbit. In order for a satellite to track a single city on Earth, it would need to be in a geostationary orbit about 36,000 kilometers above Earth. At the proposed 500 kilometers, China's satellites would face the same problems that Russia's did, whipping around Earth, quickly lighting up random places for a fraction of the second as they go, which isn't exactly the goal. And even if 500 kilometers was a typo and they meant to say 36,000, a satellite at that height would need to be extraordinarily large, hundreds of meters across, to reflect much back to Earth. And while the article doesn't specify how big China's satellites will be, launching something big enough could be prohibitively difficult. Critics also pointed out that the plan has no mention of any sort of thrusters or fuel on board these satellites. And that would probably be a necessity since out in space, the satellites, like the Russian mirrors, will experience drag and solar radiation that will eventually push them out of orbit. The cost of the initial fuel and subsequent refueling missions could outweigh any savings of electricity costs on Earth. Reportedly, researchers at several universities and institutes have looked over the plan and have given it the okay for trial, so maybe we just don't have all the details. If that's the case, and the plan does work, should we be worried? Many scientists have expressed concerns that these satellites will amplify the light pollution problems that we already have. Excess light from cities today alters the night cycles of animals, the sleep cycles of humans, and disrupts astronomers' view of space. And a project of this scale will likely make those problems worse. It's not clear in the reports whether the Chinese government has given these plans any sort of official backing, so I suppose for now, we'll just have to wait and see if any new moons light up the sky. You may not be able to launch your own illumination satellite, but you can launch your very own website with domain.com. Domain.com is awesome, affordable, reliable, and has all the tools you need to build a new website. They can fulfill all your website needs. They offer .com and .net domain names and intuitive website builders. They have over 300 domain extensions to fit your needs, from .club to .space, .pizza. Take that first step in creating an identity online and visit domain.com. For more crazy science plans, check out this playlist. And one last thing, the engineer who started the Russian satellite project actually wanted to test solar sail technology, but he found that the prospect of daylight extension was much easier to get funding for. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.